Hi everyone, I'm Craig Harper. Welcome to a very special episode of Challenge TV. This week we're taking a look at the top 10 finalists from the 2014 Challenge. It's an episode you don't want to miss, so stick around. With registrations for the next challenge opening on Monday, 9th of February, thousands of people from across the nation will again make the decision to dramatically change their physiques with 12 weeks of discipline, dedication, hard training and focused nutrition. As always, last year we took the time to meet our top 10 finalists, hear their incredible inspirational stories, find out what the challenge meant to them and the people around them, but most importantly, find out how they achieved those incredible transformations in just 12 short weeks. Believe me, they're stories which will both touch and inspire you to take your physique to the next level. And with registration for the first of this year's challenges opening this week, we thought what better time to show you it. So sit back and enjoy as we learn not only a little bit more about the challenge, but more importantly, 10 amazing blokes who changed not just their bodies, but also their lives.
I found myself as I was getting older, putting on a lot of weight.
I sat there and I looked at who I was and what I was becoming, which was 36-inch waist.
Really upset with myself.
I was actually sitting on the couch at home, having a beer and eating a packet of salt and vinegar chips.
And I was a little hesitant, and I thought, you know, before and after photos is
maybe a bit of photoshopping.
And I thought, this is it, this is 12 weeks, I have to commit.
I thought this was going to be the best chance for me to be able to do that.
I was on a roll. Once I got into a routine, that was it. The momentum was rolling and there was no stopping me.
You need to mix it up because you can't just eat chicken and broccoli the whole day.
And you're like on a roller coaster and you just want to get to the finish line.
I'm not usually lost for words, but I was.
It works. Like, this program works.
I got the body I've been chasing for years and yeah, I'm over the moon with that.
My name's Nathan Carras and I'm from East Launceston in Tasmania.
My name's Rick Longdon. I'm a police officer, 47 years old, from Perth, Western Australia.
My name's Nick and I'm from Cairns in Far North Queensland.
Chris Spratt. I live in Yolambi, Victoria.
Hi, my name's Arthur Athens. I'm almost 45 years of age. I'm a customer service manager for a bearing wholesale company.
My name's Arda. I come from Adelaide.
My name is Jacques Niaus. I'm from Wellington Point in Brisbane.
I'm a dairy farmer from Mullaney. Got a wife, three kids.
Hi, my name is Gary Ruiz. I'm from Perth, Western Australia.
My name is David Bruce. I'm a father. I'm a husband. Got two little boys. I've got a 3.5-year-old and a 9-month-old who are my life.
I found myself as I was getting older, putting on a lot of weight. I got a promotion, ended up with a desk job. Found myself that I put on 10 kilos in a year. Further than that, I gave up cigarettes, put on another 10 kilos. And before I knew it, I was extremely heavy. And everyone at work started calling me Big A. And I thought, I have to change because the quality of my life was going downhill.
Probably in the last 5 years or so, I've been like quite out of shape and looking to change. So probably in the last two to three years, I've been trying to do something about it, but it just always seemed to fail, just fall short. Very discouraged.
I just wanted to make a change. I finished playing football in 2011, started feeling old and tired and felt like my muscles wasting away because I wasn't doing anything. And I guess I got comfortable in marriage. Yeah, really wanted to make a change.
I was always pretty active in the gym, but, you know, I did a lot of cardio sort of work previously and then I got a few injuries in my legs. So I thought, man, what am I going to do from here? So I started going to the gym and then, you know, everyone wants to get big and look muscular. So I thought, I'll go straight on to trying to get big. So I started lifting weights, up my calories, and before I knew it, I was about 90-odd kilo.
I actually used to be in the industry, so I was a gym instructor when I was 18, 19 as a part-time job when I was doing my university degree. I was able to do whatever I wanted fitness-wise. I was able to really, you know, go out and go for runs and really push myself quite hard.
Unfortunately, I was injured twice quite badly that required surgery. And after I was given the all clear to begin exercising, I'd put on probably around about 10 kilograms of unwanted fat. And when I was given the all clear, I thought, oh, I'll start running and try and get it off quickly, and injured both knees.
I've always been quite an active sort of person. I've been involved in lots of different types of sports, not sort of concentrated on one or the other. The last few years, though, it's just work and life gets a bit busy and gets in the way. And I lost a bit of focus and drive. And it had been like that for some time.
About 4 years ago, I was diagnosed with Barrett's esophagus. And I thought, oh, I have to get healthy. And I started training. And as an excuse, because I was training, I thought, well, I'm doing something, but I'll keep eating whatever I wanted.
You know, we got some terrible news in January that my mom fell ill. And she's back in South Africa, and it was pretty tough to hear the news that she's got cancer. And, you know, we went back, saw her, came back to Australia, went back in April again, and things just got really bad when we were there, you know. Eating and living healthy was just not an option for me at that stage. I mean, just quickly slipped back into, you know, eating a lot and, you know, comforting myself in food. And she passed away the day we were supposed to fly back to Australia. And since then, it was difficult. I mean, we came back and dealing with her passing and the surprise of everything that happened so quickly, that was difficult.
I sat there and I looked at who I was and what I was becoming, which was 36-inch waist. That's not me. I've always had a great example from my dad. Well, why aren't I that? You know, I've got to be more of an example. It was about, I'm about to hit 40, and this is the most pivotal point, I reckon, in my life, where I either keep letting it slip or I go, no, it's got to be a change. I've got to make a change.
Well, it's my 40th birthday this December. And I promised myself in my early 30s that when I hit 40, I wanted to be in my best physical condition. And I really didn't think I'd get there.
My biggest example in my life is my father. He's 85 years old and he's super fit. He's very active. On the other hand, my mother died of bowel cancer when she was 47. So I had these two extremes in my life and I thought, what do I want to do? Where do I want to be? If I get to live to that age, how do I want to be? And that was the motivation. I thought, if I want to live long, I want to live healthy, I want to be fit. I don't want to be in my 60s and 70s struggling to walk. So the biggest goal was about looking forward and trying to be as fit and healthy as I possibly can for as long as I can.
I looked at myself in the mirror and I was upset. And I realised how bad and how much I've let myself go since January. And I picked up so much weight. And yeah, I just knew I was so unhappy. I was not coping with nothing. And I think most of it was due to my health. I mean, I was just not in a good spot. And I knew something's got to change.
Decided to do the challenge last year because I tore my bicep. Well, not tore, but I partially tore my bicep and I had to take 4 or 5 months off. And the doctor said you can't train for at least 2 to 3 weeks. And one of my mates actually said to me and said, hey, you know, the Max's challenge is coming up in 3 weeks' time. And I sort of went and said, hey, well, the doctor said I can train in 2 or 3 weeks. I can start to train. Maybe I can use that as a motivation to try to get back into shape, recover my bicep tendon and maybe get back from where I was, because I'd let myself go out and train for 5 or 6 months, ate whatever I want, you know, drinking and carrying on and whatnot. And so, yeah, I was unhappy with the way that I was. I wanted to get back into my training. I was real unfit. And that wasn't where I was from before, because I used to do bodybuilding 4 years and years ago before I shattered my arm in a motorcycle accident. Me and my partner, we just moved in together and we were, you know, eating pastas and, you know, sitting on the couch watching movies and cooking curries and that. And she came up to me one day and she's like, hey, you know, I want to do the challenge. And I was like, yeah, okay, cool. She's like, yeah, I want you to help me and you know what you're doing, you've done it before and you can help me, guide me through it, and you'll keep me motivated. So I was like, yeah, sweet, no worries. And then she said to me, it's like, well, I want you to do it with me. And that's when I sort of went back and went, oh, okay.
All right, we can, yeah, okay, we'll do it together.
If I'm gonna be training her, then I can't slack off. I can't be cheating or, you know, taking it easy and taking the backseat if I'm showing her this is what you gotta do, this is how you gotta train, and then I'm not going all out. So I was like, all right, this would be good motivation to get back into shape.
So I had a look at it on the internet and the before and after photos and everything. And I was a little hesitant. I thought, you know, before and after photos is, you know, that's a special kind of person. It's, you know, it's not the average. Not everyone can do that.
Well, I was at the gym and I saw a poster and I looked at the photo of Glenn Black on the poster and I thought that looks pretty good. Obviously, I'd been wanting to sort of get up on stage for a while, but financially it was never an option with the family.
When I saw Glenn in that picture, I was a bit of me going, oh, it's maybe a bit of photoshopping, probably long, you know, how did it happen? It's probably not real. So, you know, you question it and you think, you know, it can't be done in 12 weeks. You can't do it.
Well, I saw Glenn and we're about the same age and I thought he looked fantastic. And I thought, this is what I need to do. If this guy can do it, and I saw his before and after shot, I thought, I don't know if I could do it as well as him, but I can definitely give it a shot. And I thought, well, this is the structure I need. 12 weeks, I'll give it a shot.
I looked at Glenn's story and, you know, yeah, I do work in an office, so I thought, well, you know, we're pretty similar sort of circumstances and everything. Like, I mean, Glenn did it for health reasons and I did it just to see if it would work.
12-week challenge kind of popped up and I saw what Glenn Black did and I thought, you know, sugar me, is that real? Like, you know, I'd really like to be a part of it and looked into it more and thought, you know, I'd really like to achieve something like that, like get in the top 50 at least and see how, you know, I really pushed hard.
Funny enough, I was actually sitting on the couch at home having a beer and eating a packet of salt and vinegar chips. And it was actually a Maxine Shape Up challenge that I saw, and I recall calling out to Sandra, my wife, and saying, this might be something you're interested in. And we watched it together and we were both blown away by the transformations. And it's only then, that's when I discovered the Max's Muscle Up challenge and thought, yeah, this is for me.
I initially started the challenge, it was, my wife found it on, I think it was on TV, and said, I want to do this Maxine's challenge. Do you want to join me? I said, well, Maxine's is, you know, for ladies. She goes, oh, it's a men's Max's challenge as well. You know, I thought I needed a bit of a kickstart, a bit of a helping hand, and had a look through the website and what was available, and I thought, yeah, I'll do it. And the other thing, I thought, I definitely want to help my wife out and support her. It'll be a lot easier for her if two of us, both of us are doing it, rather than having to fix one meal for one person and then, you know, another meal for someone else because, you know, I don't want to eat what she's eating sort of thing.
Then I thought, this is it, this is 12 weeks, I have to commit. There's no turning back. Once I make the decision, I'd hate myself if I gave up.